Hello guys and welcome to another Alliance War. This time around for Loki is matching Vendix, Vendicatory. And this is a really tough alliance. We didn't face them this season and probably in a while, I don't even remember when we faced them late. But this war, it's a tough one, and this is the point in the season when we only have some tough, really wars. So next, here I'm starting on path 3, my usual, and we have here a Morningstar. And I'm trying to be a bit aggressive because you see that I have that bleed on me. It not does the problem that it does too much damage, but I'm losing so health and I need to use Namor for 2 more fights at least in this first section. Here I got to a specialty, but I decided he's just wasting time using it because I will kill her and won't regenerate. So yeah, decided to not use it. Morningstar pretty easy there. Next one we have here a Nightcrawler. Didn't see this champion placed often lately because with the flow you just want a lot of control champions. But here Nightcrawler, you can parry, so I can do normal hits, only parrying hits, and I have an invulnerability boost here for that for this fight. I think I put it on, I can't remember, sorry. But anyway, I used it really fast and lost it, and now you see that I'm playing safe. I'm just attacking when I parry, so I won't trigger evade here. I tried to use a medium, but you saw he evaded. Now here I land it. One more hit here, parry, and I use my special 3. And the point for using this is he won't die from it. So that means I can heal a bit from it. A bit meaning I will get Namor to full, because as planned, I will use Namor more than this first section. And now I'm back to full health, and with a fury, three hits and he's down. So Nightcrawler down. The invulnerability might have just saved me, because maybe 2-3 crits from Nightcrawler could melt you really fast. Anyway, I remember I wanted to play safe because this war was important for us and we really needed a win, and we knew these guys were gonna play good. And this is the fight with control. I used the invulnerability boost just to be sure. I took Ghost before in the previous war, so I was sure that I can take this fight even if it's placed on the Limber node. It's Limber, but you can still parry. That means a really short stun, or how long it is, it doesn't matter. It removes the power gain from flow, so this shouldn't be any problem. And Namor is really good for this fight because he does the reverse damage. It's a lot, and he can take the fight really fast and not waste too much time and do mistakes, because Ghost can really punish you after using a special one, and if he gets the combo on you, you might straight die. Here she uses the special 2. I again have the special 3 and I decide, okay, it's flowed, let's not fool around and finish the fight with the special 3. Okay, finishing the fight here and wait and preparing to take the next fights. Section 1, it's done here. And at the moment I'm starting in section 2. I had someone take the first fight for me because it was a man thing on Vigor, and I was thinking maybe that can help Thing or Void. That was a big discussion about it with the officers in our beta group, and we decided, because backup wasn't needed on another path, we sent someone from backup with a Warlock, which is the best answer for that man thing. Unfortunately, I don't have Warlock on my account, only a 4-star, so yeah, that wasn't an option for me to bring. Maybe sometime I will get it, but yeah, so they took Warlock down, and we could have tried and risk it in another war and just let me try with Void or Thing, but this war was so close, we were tied a lot of the time, so we really needed to not die and to take risk in any fights. So here, I didn't talk yet about this fight, it's the usual Doom here. And pretty much nothing difficult, just building passive fears on Thing and building to a special 3s and baiting his special 1 as much as I can. And you'll see here, this guy didn't place with 5 in Mystic Dispersion, so that helps a bit, but it doesn't matter really. I just want to build to the special tree here. Wanted to parry again because the rock stacks are almost going away. Getting the bonus Fury and trying to do some damage to this Doom and finish the fight in time. This fight it's pretty standard, and with Thing, because you don't care about Buffett, it's really easy. I mean, I think you can, if you don't have Thing, Quake, it's a really good answer for this. You can Quake this champion really easy. Void can probably do it, but with a shock damage, I don't know if I would risk it. But Thing, yeah, it's a great option. Probably Warlock too is a really good option. There are a lot of, there are some options for this. But anyway, sticking with Thing here, because I'm comfortable, using him, and I've been doing this for a few seasons already, so yeah, Thing for Pet 1, it's really good. And the main reason is he's immune to Nullify, that means you can't lose buffs from Buffett. Here, his special 2, stand, one more combo, even though I push him to the special 3. Even if he survived to the combo, I had a special 1 ready, and I wasn't afraid of something. Here, we have this Mr. Fantastic, which it's a pretty interesting placement, and it's a rank 5 star. And I decided to use Void here. I knew that using whatever champion I use in this fight, I would be able to, I will get for sure the passive weakness on my specials, which will carry to the next fights. And from what I had planned for the next fights, I knew that this is the only fight I'll be using Void. So I decided, okay, I'll use Void for this. And as you know, or maybe not, however many debuffs Mr. Fantastic has on him, he increases the evade chance with each debuff. So Void, it's a bit of a counter, but it's countered itself, because Void can reduce evade with his debuffs. But he plays so many debuffs that Mr. Fantastic still evades. And that's why you see I'm only hitting on parries, just to not risk it. And now that I have the debuffs and Buffett, it works now. I just trigger Buffett as much as I can in this fight to reverse his health and to kill him really fast. Mr. Fantastic doesn't hit that hard, so you can get a lot of hits in the face and don't care. Here I will try and trigger the dexterity, triggered it, and you saw 10% loss. So I use this in my advantage to finish the fight faster and to not give any opportunities to die. And now Mr. Fantastic down, Void really good for this fight. Okay, pretty easy fight there. Next on we have a Medusa here on the debuff immune, and 5 Medusa. And here you see I'm not healing Void to full, although it's a close war. 70%, it's enough health. And this is a special one, power lock one node, so you can't get more than one bar of power. But that means a debuff which will power you here. First, after I get to the first special one, I use my special one to get the passive fury so I can have some damage. And from now on, I'll just never use the special one, only to end the fight, just to heal a bit more from willpower. I'm not afraid here that Medusa can kill me. I'm really confident in playing this fight, and that's why I didn't heal to full. Although maybe it was time, or it's always a risk to die in any fight, so yeah. But anyway, I wanted to heal from the willpower. And the plan here for Medusa is whenever he has our beta special, whenever she has three furies, to not risk getting auto-blocked, I do only one hit medium. Or if I make her use a heavy, I throw my heavy, which is 3 hits, so that's why I think works really good here. And you see that I enter 70% and I'm now at 80% and still healing, baiting the special one hit here. And I trigger here. You think why I triggered their parry? Well, I triggered it because I know each parry just triggers it directly protection if it's not in cooldown on Thing. And yeah, that's why I triggered it. Now healing a bit more, and now I want to bait one more special here and one hit. I'm trying to use my heavy, but she didn't come at me. Now that I'm full, I don't really care about the health anymore. I'm just from heavies and trying to make her attack me, so I trigger unstoppable. Yeah, that fight went pretty good. And next, for the last two fights of the war, we have some name or action here. First on this interesting fight, on the counter tactics mini boss, I switch back to suicides. There is a Terax here, which I attacked in the previous war. It's a control champion, so he benefits from flow. And after he uses a special, he gets this aura like death field from Omega Red, from his special tomb. And with flow here, I just need to land some crits so I can trigger his power gain, and he will have this infinite power gain, so he won't get out of this phase, and he won't have to use specials anymore, because whenever he gets into this phase, he can't use specials. But as you see, I am trying to bait his heavies here, but he just throws a lot of hits in my block, and it's counter tactics, so as high my combo goes, as high his damage goes. And that's why hitting in the block takes a lot of, makes him hit really hard, even though Terax has a low damage. And here I get afraid, okay, I can't take too much block hits. I go for a nice intercept there. I use another special tree again. This should kill him, I'm hoping. I dropped really low there because that aura that he has does a lot of damage on the counter tactics plus the block hits. And now, and kill from the special tree. So I was a bit lucky there that I didn't die. Could have get one more hit in the block or something like that and got killed. But Namor reverses all the damage when you attack, so that's why I survived it. But this means healing again Namor. We have some discussions about this node. I was supposed to take Terax, but I wasn't supposed to take this stealth suit Spider-Man. And I told my officers, because we needed someone for other fight, that I'm really confident I can take this fight, and they said okay, take it, and I thank them for their trust. And this is the kinetic mini boss, and with how many hits stealth fight he can throw, and really fast, I need to be careful, and plus the evade plus plague mind that removes my power. This is a bit tricky fight, but I knew what I expect. I will try and trigger the evade and dash back after one hit. It's limber, so I don't have many parries, but I use them at the beginning here to get a bit of the rhythm of the fight. Now he used a special one. He gets the evade, one hit. I didn't trigger it, so okay. Now I'm trying to hit his block a bit. Bait again the special one. Now go in, trigger the evade, and go for the combo straight after that. I was lucky there I didn't get punished. I was really fast. But yeah, the fight is going pretty well here. But I have to be careful because one combo can kill me. And I'm playing a bit risky, it seems, because I'm dashing a lot in and out. And that means a lot of openings for him to intercept me. But yeah, this is the plan I had in mind. This is how I wanted to play, dance around, jump around a lot, until I get my special train, finish it, or finish after that. And don't let him get too much power, because if he got too much power, the special 2, if he uses it and I have to block it, it's special 2 back to special 2 because of kinetic, so that wouldn't have been a great time. But here, stealth is down. Really happy how I did this war. Didn't die, took some hard fights. And yeah, I was happy about this finishing. And he survived a bit better, but doesn't matter. Anyway, guys, we won this and it was really close. I think we won by one or two kills. And yeah, some tough wars are coming. Stay tuned. Bye, guys.